Okay, so we have this error, MetaQuest link app status, can't reach MetaQuest link service. So how can we fix this? I'm going to hit that repair app. So nothing won't happen, so you won't fix the error like this. You just have to actually manually open the service, because I don't know why, but they don't check these services, they don't care. So it says here already installed. Looks like we already installed MetaQuest link, so you can only quit here, open MetaQuest link, uninstall or repair. If I'm going to repair it, nothing will happen because I already tried it. It's going to download again the MetaQuest and reinstall the app, so this won't fix the issue. Right now I'm waiting for the MetaQuest link software to install. After a period of time, I get this message. So I'm going to restart the computer to see if this helps. Right now I'm going into the settings and I'm going to the system, and if you're going here into the software updates, we can see that we actually don't have the last update. So in order to make the connection, you actually have to update your MetaQuest 2 or MetaQuest 3. So I'll have to update it. So I'm going to hit here on the software update, the software update button, and I'm going to wait. You can actually see things around, and I can see that MetaQuest improved the hand tracking, because it's really easy to work right now with only using one hand. The tracking is really okay. The only complaining is that you have to have light inside your room, so in the night period, if you don't have any light open, this movement detection won't happen. Let's see what is going to happen. Okay, so after I did that update, we can see that on the software update, we don't have any update. If I'm going here under the quest link right now and I'm trying to reconnect to my PC, we can see that it says search for PC, use AirLink, but quest PC app is not opening on my PC, and I don't know why. And it's saying checking the status of your MetaQuest link app status, and it's staying like that, is not doing anything, so I don't know why. We have to enter on C program, Oculus support, Oculus drive after you try to install the application, and run this Oculus driver.exe and install this. So I'm going to run this, that's all. And after that, we have to restart the computer. Well, if you have a wireless like mine, and you have this configuration, you might have this configuration, and you actually have to disable this smart connect, and you have to enable a 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi connection. And we can see that here on the channel bandwidth, we can select these values. We have 80. You just have to set up password and save settings. Then let's try to reconnect. So I'm going to stop this and restart this application. Actually, it haven't worked. So another fix will be to delete the remote headset. Can see that we have two versions here, but I'm actually going to delete both of them. I'm going to hit the delete. I'm going to continue. Continue. When I deleted both of them, and right now I'm trying to reconnect, so I'm going to restart this, and also I'm going to reconnect on the Quest 2. Then we go here into this OVR service. We're going to end task, then let's restart this. And as we can see, the application actually started. So this was the final fix, and we can see that the application is starting. So right now, let me close this one. Let's see if we can connect the Quest 2. So I'm going to access the Quest 2. So yeah, the problem is that it is searching for the PC, but PC is not appearing, so you actually have to reconnect using the VR cable first, and maybe after that this will fix the problem. And here I'm going to remove the device. Okay, and we can see that we can add another device, so I'm going to add another Quest 2. Okay, and I'm going to press the AirLink wireless. And right now I'm going to launch Airlink from my Quest 2. So it haven't worked, so I'm going to hit this back and I'm going to use the link cable. And right now I'm going to connect the link cable. Okay, so after I try to connect with an USB cable, I figure out why it won't work. So if you're looking here on this page on the Windows PC requirements to use the MetaQuest Link, we can see that we have the minimum PC requirements. Also, we have the recommended PC requirements here, but this is not a problem. The problem is here, supported GPU for Link, so we can see that some GPUs are not supported, and I actually have right now this GPU, and as you can see, this GPU is actually not currently supported. I try to connect with the USB cable and I don't know why it is not working. It is only charging the headset, it's not doing anything else. So as you can see, there are some GPUs that are not actually supported, and also we have some GPUs for the laptops which are also not supported. So I think we actually have to wait a little bit. It's really sad because before, I know, like 1 year ago, this feature worked. So right now it's not working because I have this GPU. So this is not cool, you know. Guess what, it's not finding my PC.
Okay, so I find out a way to connect your USB because I couldn't connect my MetaQuest, my USB. So I've connected the Quest 2. This is the first step, and after that, if I'm going to run this command, we're gonna see that automatically a prompt will be open and I'll be able to use my internal files from my Quest 2, but only after I use this command. So the question is, what command is used for running the, not this type of connection, but the MetaQuest Link connection from this MetaQuest Link? Because if I'm going here and I'm trying to connect, after I disconnect and I reconnect, here nothing is happening, only this opening is happening because I tried this command. So if I'm going to close this shell, I'm disconnecting from the USB, I'm reconnecting it. Okay, so I'm going to try another thing. I'm going to shift delete the Oculus from program files. I'm going to continue. So I'll delete everything from Oculus and I'm going to install the Quest Link. I did the repairing on the application, but after I repaired it, they actually deleted old application or something like that. So I'm going to reinstall it. And after doing that, we can see that we still get this message and it's not working. Okay, so right now I've connected the USB 2.0. So it's a simple cable USB 2.0 to my headset, and I'm going to run this command here. You can see that I have this message, and right now we have this another message. So if I'm going to reconnect, I'm going to reconnect the USB cable, I can see that no message is, no error is thrown or something like that. But the Quest 2 is not finding my PC, so this is sad. So I'm going to try this command, adb devices, and we can see that we have one device here. After that, just type this command and we can see that we have this first init. So we need this this link here. After this command, we're going to try another one, which is this one. So I'm going to hit this one. I'm going to restart the port 555, and after that I'm going to use, okay, so I've uninstalled the Quest Link and I reinstalled it, and after I open the application, I can see this error message, can't reach MetaQuest Link service.
Okay, so I'll explain you what is the problem, and unfortunately I couldn't fix it. If you're going here into the settings, we can see that we can't find the PC, though it has the application opened and it is connected with the same network. So the Quest Link isn't working. But the problem is that if I'm going to access the developer, I can't see any option for the USB message pop up, you know. There isn't any option. These are all the options here. You can enable and disable them. And when I'm trying to connect the headset to the computer with the USB, I can't see the files. I don't know why, but it's not working anymore. I try to disable the developer from the application on my phone. And after that, when I entered on the developer, I still can see this developer page here. But I don't know where are the USB settings, because if I'm trying to connect the headset to the computer, I can't do anything. So what I want to try right now is to connect the headset to the mobile phone, to the phone, to see if I'm having any message. Nothing is happening. I only hear this pop up, this message. I'm disconnecting it. And I'm reconnecting to my mobile phone. Nothing is happening. So I don't know how can I fix this problem. If I'm going to connect it again, I can hear a message on my phone, but I can't see any message, you know, on the screen. So yeah, this was everything that I want to show you, and maybe someone will fix this without resetting the headset, because I don't really want to reset the headset settings to the default, the factory reset, you know. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.
That is really strange. So yeah, that was everything. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.